Kia ora, and hello from beautiful Aotearoa, New Zealand. Welcome back to the Azure Security Community Channel. My name's Sarah Young, and I'm Senior Program Manager in our Azure Security Customer Experience Engineering team. Today, I want to talk to you about all the different APIs that we have in Azure Sentinel, how you can use them, and what you should use them for. We've got quite a lot to talk about here, so let's go to the whiteboard. So I'm just going to talk about the different APIs that we have within Azure Sentinel. As you can see from this diagram, broadly, we group them into four buckets. We have the Management API, we have the Graph Security API, the HTTP Data Collector API, and the Log Analytics API. I'm going to talk about all of these APIs briefly so you can understand what they're used for in the context of Azure Sentinel. So firstly, we have the Graph Security API. This is, in the context of Azure Sentinel, largely used for threat intelligence, or TI. So with the Graph Security API, we can get alert info from other Microsoft products. We can also post alert info to other Microsoft products, and we can also receive alerts from third parties as well. Finally, that allows us to ingest threat intelligence into Sentinel. So when you ingest threat intelligence into Sentinel via the Graph Security API, it will put it into the threat intelligence indicator table. Now, if you ingest TI in any other manner, it would go to a custom log. We don't have time in this video to talk about the advantages and disadvantages of doing it in that way, but we'll try and post some links below about the differences there so you can read up on it. Secondly, we'll talk about the Log Analytics API. Now, this one isn't new either. This has been around as long as Log Analytics, and it's an API that you can use to query the data stored in your Log Analytics workspace. You'll know that Log Analytics, of course, sits underneath every single instance we have of Azure Sentinel. So it is a way that you can query the data within your Sentinel and Log Analytics workspace together. So it's still relevant to mention here. So if you need to query via an API interface the data in your Log Analytics workspace, this is a way to do it. Then I'll talk about the HTTP Data Collector API. This is in preview at the time I'm recording this, and this is a way that we can take HTTP data and collect it and put it into a Log Analytics workspace. If we look at this diagram, you can see here, we've got JSON formatted data and via an Azure function, and that can be in C#, PowerShell, Python, various different programming languages, we can put that into your Log Analytics workspace. The other way to do that is using logic apps, and the JSON formatted data would go into logic apps where we can parse it, and then we would use the Log Analytics connection through logic apps to put that data into a workspace. Now, that's of course a very, very brief overview of how that works. We also have a very simple example of how you can use the Data Collector API in our GitHub repo, which we'll provide links to. But this is definitely something that you can consider when you're wanting to ingest data into a Log Analytics workspace if you can't do it via any other means. Finally, I wanted to talk about the Sentinel Management API. Now, the Sentinel Management API is the newest of our APIs, and this exists to enable you to manage parts of Azure Sentinel that are specifically outside of Log Analytics. So, for example, incidents or analytics rules. As you can see here, we've also got updating data connectors and bookmarks and entities. Now, what we've got here in this diagram is not comprehensive. This is just a quick overview of some of the things you can do with the management API. But what we recommend you do is go and check out our GitHub repo, where you can see the full branch of the API and you can have a look at all the different things you can do. We also do have an accompanying post to this video on our MS Tech community, where we'll talk about some of the tools that you can use. I particularly recommend going and looking at Wirtel's Azure Sentinel PowerShell tool that allows you to update some of these rules and things in Sentinel using the management API. So there you have it. There are all the cool things that you can do with APIs in Azure Sentinel. That was just a really quick overview. So do experiment for yourself and explore. And if you have any questions or comments, leave them in the video below or put them on the MS Tech community. If you've done anything cool with APIs, don't forget to upload it to our GitHub repo. Don't forget to subscribe to the Azure Security Community channel for more videos and updates on our other Azure Security products. And we'll see you soon. Matewa.